The first of five pillars of Islam is the declaration or testimony of faith, called Shahada in Arabic, to which every Muslim must adhere. The word Shahada in Arabic linguistically translates to testifying, bearing witness. The Shahada is the Islamic creed. The Shahada contains two parts, both of which a Muslim must testify to and believe. The first part requires the believer to testify that no deity is worthy of worship, veneration, or complete devotion other than Allah. A Muslim acknowledges that Allah has the exclusive right to be worshipped, venerated, loved, inwardly and outwardly, by one's heart, tongue, and limbs. A Muslim accepts Allah as the only God, Master, Lord, and Ruler. Allah is not a foreign God, as Allah is the Arabic name for God. Islam states that God does not have any partners or associates in worship. No other deity, being, or idol is worthy of worship. The act of worshipping any other besides Allah is the biggest sin in Islam, standing as the only sin that is not forgiven if a person dies in that state without repenting. Regretfully, many have regarded certain historical figures as their gods and deities who are wrongfully worshipped and venerated. Whether they are idols, superstitions, saints, ideologies, ways of life, or any other authority figures who claim to be divine or semi-divine, even though they themselves are creations and have no power to bring any benefit or harm to anyone. But they have taken besides him gods which created nothing, while they are created, and possess none for themselves any harm or benefit, and possess none power to cause death or life or resurrection. The belief in worshipping the one God is considered the central message of all of God's prophets and messengers, who were sent to mankind to deliver his message. This was the message of Prophet Adam, Prophet Noah, Prophet Abraham, Prophet Moses, Prophet Jesus, and Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon them all. And we certainly sent into every nation a messenger saying, worship Allah and avoid false deities. Through verbally stating these words, believing in them, acting and living upon them, one enters the fold of Islam. Simply stating these words verbally without action does not complete a Muslim. The second part of the testimony requires the believer to testify that Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of God. In accepting Prophet Muhammad as the seal of the prophets, one affirms the belief that his prophecy confirms and fulfills all of the previously revealed messages, beginning with Prophet Adam. Whereas Muslims believe in all the previous messengers and prophets of God, Islam states Prophet Muhammad is both a messenger and prophet of God, one who carries a higher role than all the previous messengers and prophets before him. Prophet Muhammad was a mere mortal with no share in divinity, who was chosen by God as the last and final messenger to the last nation, our nation. Muhammad is not the father of one of your men, but he is the messenger of Allah, and the last of the prophets, and ever is Allah of all things knowing. A Muslim is required to fully carry out and practice the instructions given by Prophet Muhammad, as commanded by God the Almighty. Prophet Muhammad also serves as the best role model for mankind that ever stepped foot on earth by way of his exemplary life. Muslims are encouraged to make a substantial effort to follow and emulate Prophet Muhammad's examples, manners, generosity, good habits, politeness, respect, gentleness, noble feelings, and way of life to the best of their ability, reflecting an emphasis on Islam and the Holy Quran. There has certainly been for you in the Messenger of Allah an excellent pattern for anyone whose hope is in Allah and the Last Day, and who remembers Allah often. These two phrases are the most frequently repeated words in the world, as hundreds of millions of practicing Muslims repeat these words dozens of times throughout their day and by way of their prayers. It is recommended for a believer to say it when they first rise in the morning and before they go to bed. These words reflect and encompass every dimension of a Muslim's life. The Shahada, or testimony of faith, is by far the most important aspect of Islam, as it affirms the belief in the oneness and the uniqueness of Allah, upon which the whole religion of Islam is built upon, and all other beliefs hinge. It is the central belief that a Muslim adheres to his entire life. Verbally stating these words and living by them is unquestionably the greatest and most important duty of a Muslim. Unless one acknowledges this testimony, he or she cannot be a Muslim. Muslims strain to utter these words as their last spoken before departing this world, since whoever does so has been promised a destiny of God-given paradise. However, only the ones that lived and acted upon these words will be granted the ability to utter these blessed sentiments in the form of their final words. Our Prophet narrated, "Whoever guides another to a good deed will get a reward similar to the one who performs it." So please like, subscribe, and share this video. Assalamu alaikum.